I remember sitting there one day, and it was towards the end of the winter of 2009, and I kept on saying, and I kept on asking this question: well, when is this market ever going to go up again? Is this market literally going to ever go up again? And that was 2007 to 2009. I remember a lot of things happened in between, and it felt like the market was never going to go up again.
Welcome to Access a Trader, the number one community for those who are committed to taking control of their trading in order to achieve success, profitability, and longevity. Thank you for joining us. Here's Dan Shapiro to help you find your edge, master your process, and own your future.
Hey guys, good evening everybody. Welcome to another edition of the accessatrader.com nightly wrap-up show. Hope everybody's doing well. So let's talk about the market. So yesterday we talked about the indecision, right? The indecision of the tape. Bulls couldn't reclaim top of supply. Bears couldn't reclaim the bottom of demand of the 5-day. And something had to give today. I mean, that was kind of a big deal. And if you've been watching this broadcast for a while now, you know, it's been pretty clear, where the sell bias was, and it's been out there for everybody to see. And you know, this wasn't just, you know, today's sell off just wasn't one day in the making. You know, we've been talking about the weakness in tech and beta for a long time. Matter of fact, we've been talking about this channel every single, you know, way down, every single way up, the really big areas, lines in the sand, so forth and so on. And again, it's never a pissing contest with investors or traders. It's about being, you know, who, you know, I've always said this, I'm an idiot. You know, I don't give my opinions. I let the price action tell me where the next movement's going to be. So this has nothing to do with, look at me, listen, that's nothing to do with that. Okay, my main focus every night in this video is not tell you, you know, where I think the market's going. It's pretty much put you in a situation of strength that if there are any red flags, there's, you know, any bells and whistles and potential fire alarms to be sounded, you're protected, right? If you are an investor and you watch this broadcast, and again, you know, we're pretty much a trading channel. I trade channels every single day, long, short, it doesn't make a difference, but it's all about what the daily chart is telling us. And if you've been watching this broadcast now for, you know, for even for a short period of time, it's pretty easy to see, you know, which way we've been leaning every single day. The value in the market every single day has been pretty much to the downside. Even if you guys remember a couple of days ago, we had that 600 point rally on the Dow and the 300 point rally on the Nasdaq, and I literally said this was one of the worst not only rallies that I saw, but the poorest quality of value to the upside. And the next day, obviously, we got rejected. We talked about this last night in the video. The bulls needed to reclaim 324. The bears needed to reclaim this 318 level. But the big number, if you've been watching this broadcast, has been this 311. 311 has been the line in the sand three times in a row. And, you know, this should have been kind of like etched into your brain. Now, again, I know a lot of people are very, very emotional right now. And I know a lot of you guys have started in the bull market, right? In the last four and a half years, this has been one of the biggest, probably, you know, one of the biggest runs the bulls have been into, right? And I see a lot of people talking about this, you know, today. Well, what caused this rally? I mean, what caused this decline? Guys, keep this in mind, okay? After the mortgage mess, and the mortgage mess started in 2007, it went all the way to 2009. A lot of people lost jobs, a lot of foreclosures, people lost their homes, a lot of companies went bankrupt, the Lehman's, the Bear Stearns, so forth and so on. I remember sitting there, and this isn't the first time I've kind of said this. I remember sitting there one day, and it was towards the end of the winter of 2009, and I kept on saying, and I kept on asking this question: well, when is this market ever going to go up again? Is this market literally going to ever go up again? And that was 2007 to 2009. I remember a lot of things happened in between, and it felt like the market was never going to go up again. And then lo and behold, 2009 was the generational bottom to kind of where we are today. You're talking about now, you know, you're talking about 10, 11, 12 years of very, very big aggression. So the idea that you need news, the idea that there has to be a specific catalyst to take the market lower, it kind of doesn't make sense. The same way it didn't make sense that the market finally stopped going up in 2009, and that was the kind of the generational bottom. So when you're looking at your charts tonight and you're looking at your positions or your holdings, if you are an investor, again, you know, I'm speaking from the trader's point of view. I'm trying to be as careful with my words, because I know so many people are so brand new to this business, and they're so fragile, and words really hurt their feelings and stuff like that. But the reality is, if you do not grasp the reality, you're going to be in a very, very awkward and aggressive place. So when the dot-com bubble started to pop, nobody sat down to us and said, you know what? We've seen this before, okay? This is euphoria. Euphoria is going to end, and eventually, you know, you're going to be waking up to a very, very aggressive reality. And we turned around and said, you're crazy, right? We were all young kids, 24, 25 years old. We were all young kids back in 2000. You're crazy. This is going to go on forever. Yada, yada, yada. It went on for about 15 months. And the one thing that we always talk about, if you are an investor, if you are a trader, if you are an investor, think long term, right? You know, always think long term. If you love Apple, hold on to Apple. If you love Amazon, hold on to Amazon, Facebook and Tesla and everything in between. But if you are a trader, or if you're a proactive investor that does monitor their portfolio on a week to week basis, on a year to year basis, your job is to really make sure that you're trading or you're investing in a position of strength, or compared to a position of weakness. And you always have to ask yourself, what has changed? Has anything changed? Has the narrative changed? Am I doing everything possible to make sure that I don't have the rose-colored glasses on, that I'm not sitting here hoping for something to happen, that I'm hoping my stock rebounds and everything will be good tomorrow? Maybe it will, but maybe it won't. And our job as traders, and whether you're a professional trader who's been doing this for two decades plus, or you're starting out in your first year or so, you are a professional trader. Your money is just as good as my money, is just as good as anybody's money who's putting it in the middle of the table, and they are betting the success of their process. So you're as good as anybody else. So the difference between Steve Cohen and Joe Schmo from Nebraska is just, Steve Cohen has a lot more money than you, but you are putting your money on the line, and you have to make sure you're doing the best possible way to not only for your money to come back with friends, but you're protecting your capital in the most part. So here we are, right? Here we are here. And today, yesterday, I just couldn't get going yesterday. And today we woke up, we knew the levels, and that was the key. I think the preparation was the most important part. And I got tons of emails after the close, and I know a lot of you guys did incredibly well today. But the most important part was not about fear-mongering what was going to happen today or might happen today or what's going to happen tomorrow. It's not about that. I would never do that. I would never put that energy or put that nonsense into space. We're just trying to make sure that everybody's protected and just understanding what could happen next. And if you believe in technical analysis and you do believe in the theory that stocks go up and stocks go down, well then, continue watching this channel. If you're in the position of my stock is the best, it'll never go down, look at the fundamentals, okay, cool. But this is just not the reality, right? It's just ask all those people who bought stock anywhere in late 2000, what happened to their portfolios? The greatest stocks in the world couldn't, face the wrath of, the tidal wave and the dot-com bubble pop, what was about to happen. And again, nobody's saying this market's going to zero. It's not about that. We're just trying to identify levels, trade off those levels, make sure that we understand what potentially could happen next, and then move along. That's it. We're just trying to win the day. We're just trying to win the interval. And if you are a long-term investor, my channel is not for you, okay? You're going to be fine. 20 years from now, 5 years from now, 3 years from now, you're going to be fine. This is for the active trader who trades channels, who believes in the day-to-day accessibility of strength and weakness in the market, and our job is just to identify it and try to take advantage. So here we are, very, very aggressive move down. We'll talk about the pivots in a second. Number one, two things happened today. Say that five times fast. Number one, we opened below the 318 level that we talked about last night and right away reclaimed it. And as soon as we reclaimed it, stocks got stuffed. A lot of names got stuffed very, very quickly back in their channels, and they started selling off. But the key to the whole day was what we saw around here, which was the 311 area, okay? And, you know, last three times we held this 311 area, and the question was it finally going to break today? Is it finally going to reclaim the lows that we've set for the last 2 weeks or so? And we got the answer. It took out the 311 area, went to 309. And again, if you believe in the theory that stocks trade from supply to supply and demand to demand, you have to believe this 306 area should be tested in the next couple of days. Is it possible the market has a relief rally tomorrow? Yeah, sure. Why not? Right? Why not? I mean, the NASDAQ was down nearly 400 points today. Why can't we have a relief rally tomorrow? But the moral of the story is now this becomes supply. That 11 area does become supply. And if the bulls can't maintain any type of aggressive rally tomorrow, then there's an area here, this 306, 307 area that we are going to test, whether it's tomorrow or the next day, whatever the case may be. You know, we'll get to that when we get to that. But more important was that 305 level that we've been talking about in nausea for a very, very long time. And any close, and again, maybe this is putting the cart in front of the horse, but any close below 305, you can see how much room you have down and how much, you know, how much aggressive escalation there possibly could be after that. So, you know, tomorrow, you know, I'm open-minded. I am, you know, I'm obviously continue to be sell biased. Even if the indexes do rally, there's tons and tons of stocks that closed today right near their macro support. And if they confirm tomorrow, you know, they don't need the NASDAQ to be down for them to get clipped, right? And we'll see, I'll show you in a second the pivots today. There was a monster pivots today. I caught Zoom, I caught Nvidia. Netflix got murdered. I mean, the word murder was just, maybe I'm understating it. Just things got really, really hit today. And the craziest part, and I was talking about that in the middle of the day, the craziest part was majority of these stocks haven't even taken down their macro levels. So if you look at Netflix, for example, right? If you look at Netflix, Netflix held, right? Netflix held. Look at this. You got a three bottom here. This bottom eventually gets confirmed. Look how much room you have down. Facebook, right, has a bottom here. It held like 38 times, or at least four, right? If this bottom gets hit, this thing has a lot more room down. If you look at Apple, right, Apple hasn't even taken down this last week's low yet. If Apple starts confirming this area, then it goes down to here. And if it confirms that, then it goes lower. And then you had stocks like Zoom that got crushed today, finally took out the bottom of the range. If it confirms down tomorrow, there's more selling. Nvidia, which was a phenomenal trade today, just absolutely phenomenal trade today, got destroyed, just absolutely destroyed, took down this whole formation. And now you're looking at 503 as the next stop, right? That's the next measure potential. If it gets below 503, then you got 490, 480s coming up. So there's a lot of stocks still on deck tomorrow. Look at NIO, right? Look at NIO. NIO is one day away from confirming the lows from last week. This thing could get clipped, right? There's so many, look at Target, even a name that has nothing to do with technology. Target had a horrible move yesterday. It kind of quote unquote put in an inside day. If it starts confirming, look how much room it has down. So the more important part of what we're seeing today, folks, is number one, gravity is real. It's not personal. Trust me, it's not personal. I don't wish anybody's portfolio to bleed or to get hurt. I understand everybody's an adult. People have kids. I get it. I have kids as well. I would never in a million years make this a personal thing, but you have to keep this in mind. Stocks go up and they go down. It's just the reality of this business. Unfortunately, many people take it very, very personally, and they try to make excuses. They blame others. The market, look, at the end of the day, 100 years from now, we're all going to be gone, right? We're all going to be distant memories. The market will either still go up or go down without you. So it's very, very important to understand it's not personal. Gravity is real. Technical analysis is incredibly important to your survival, to make really tactical moves. And the most important part is protect your capital at all costs. And if you are getting aggressive action or aggressive potential to the downside of the market, take advantage of it. I've been saying this for years. God gave you two hands, two eyes, two ears, two feet, right? You could trade both sides of the market, but be very, very conscious of the ability of the market to turn on a dime, have an open mind on both sides, and make sure that you are in business. So let's talk about today's session. Again, guys, congratulations. Just a monster moves today. It was primarily all shorts today. It really was. There was two pivots to the upside, one SOS, one LUMS that I still like. NVIDIA 532 is daily and 60-minute support. If it builds below, it can flush. This thing got murdered. NVIDIA got absolutely murdered. I shorted it, and not only did it started taking down that 32 level, it took out down that 528 level and went all the way down to close at 512. Just destruction, absolute destruction in the name. Tesla confirmed everything today, just absolutely everything. If it opens above 685 in the regular session, and it did, it starts building below. Watch that 685 number. That was the last support the last 2 days. If it opens below, watch that 678, 60-minute Bollinger Band. And if it confirms, yeah, it confirmed. It absolutely confirmed. And not only did it confirm, right? So here was 685, hit 685. It took out the previous week's low of 659, closed at 653. If today's action gets confirmed, then you have to start looking at a measure potential of 619, which is the February 23 lows. Again, unfortunately, that's just the reality to where we are. Roku destroyed 388. If it builds below, it can flush. Here is Roku, right? Here is the 388, right? Took out this whole channel here. Here's the 388, which was yesterday's low, and confirmed macro at 378 and closed all the way down to 367. If 367 loses tomorrow, then you have more room. You have another $12 to $15 worth to the next measure potential. So, you know, watch that as well. Lemonade, I didn't have a locate for some reason on Lemonade, and I didn't want to borrow it. I'm cheap. 110, 109, if it builds below, it can flush. Lemonade got murdered. I mean, absolutely murdered. So here is the 110 area, 109, went all the way down to 102. You know, again, still looks lower for tomorrow. Netflix massacred. 542, 541, if it builds below, it can flush. And it flushed. It really, really flushed. It took out this whole channel here. And now I'm watching it for macro levels for tomorrow. You see how it held three times in the same spot? Once, twice, three times, lady. This thing gets confirmed tomorrow. There's a lot of room down. So I'm definitely watching Netflix for tomorrow. And to the upside, it was actually some trades to the upside. LUMN, they were coming for the $13.50 for the $14 weeklies. 13-10, 13-20 needs to build to the upside. Look at this thing did. It's actually closed nearly the high of the day. If this thing confirms $14 tomorrow and there is a bounce in the market, who knows? Maybe this thing wakes up even more. So keep an eye on that. But that was a nice move there. FBIO never got to 510. GRTS just touched that 550 and completely died. Nothing there. ZM was really good. I shorted ZM. 371, if it builds below, can flush more. Here was ZM, right? Took out the 371, traded all the way down to the 340s. This thing confirms tomorrow, gets just hit again. And that's it. Take on the way down. Zoom, take on the way down. NVIDIA, I guess, bang, right? Just a fantastic, fantastic opening. Facebook, I love for tomorrow, assuming it, you know, confirms. Roku's getting hit. New lows on Tesla, just one after another. Lumina, new highs. And SOS, congratulations. Again, I was out to lunch. I didn't see this, but great job there, guys. SOS rejected two times at 850. If it builds, can go. Buyer came in for the 319, $10 calls. And this thing was actually a nice move here, right? It took out the 850 and went to 9.25 before kind of retracing. So a lot of stuff going on. Again, folks, this isn't, you know, unfortunately, this isn't, you know, Disney World, and everybody's going to tell you all the good things, that everything's going to be okay, your portfolio is going to come back, these stocks are going to come back. Maybe they will, maybe they won't. But the point is, folks, the faster you adapt and adopt the theory, how important technical analysis is, the better and the faster you are going to be in control of your trading. I hope everybody's doing well. I hope everybody's safe. I hope God continues to bless you all. And with God's help, I'll see you all tomorrow. Take care, guys.